Greater. Greater. Toaster. Toaster. Kettle. Kettle. Whisk. Whisk. Rolling pin. Rolling pin. Blender. Blender. Chopping board. Chopping board. Wooden spoon. Wooden spoon. Apron. Apron. Bowl. Bowl. Teapot. Teapot. Spatula. Spatula. Strainer. Strainer. Ladle. Ladle. Cleaver. Cleaver. Oven glove. Oven glove. Corkscrew. Corkscrew. Plate. Knife. Knife. Fork. Fork. Spoon. Spoon. Frying pan. Frying pan. Saucepan. Saucepan. Cake slicer. Cake slicer. Colander. Colander. Baking tray. Baking tray. Casserole dish. Casserole dish. Vegetable peeler. Vegetable peeler. Ice cream scoop. Ice cream scoop. Can opener. Can opener. Bottle opener. Bottle opener. Cork. Cork. Microwave. Microwave. Electric cooker. Electric cooker. Dishwasher. Fridge. Fridge. Scales. Scales. Measuring jug. Measuring jug. Chopsticks. Chopsticks. Glass. Glass. Mug. Mug. Cupboard. Kitchen sink. Kitchen sink. Jug. Jug. Napkin. Napkin. Pestle. Pestle. Mortar. Mortar. Wok. Wok. Garlic crusher. Garlic crusher. Zester. Zester. Potato masher. Potato masher. Salad spinner. Salad spinner. Butter dish. Butter dish. Salt mill. Salt mill. Pepper mill. Pepper mill. Sponge. Sponge. Olive oil. Olive oil. Fire extinguisher. Fire extinguisher. Milk. Milk. Bread. Bread. Eggs. Eggs. Sugar. Sugar. Rubbish bin. Rubbish bin. Kitchen table. Kitchen table. Ice tray. Ice tray. Spice rack. Spice rack. Scouring pad. Scouring pad. Tea bag. Tea bag. Coffee granules. Coffee granules. Stool. Stool. Electric fan. Electric fan. Food processor. Food processor. Waffle maker. Waffle maker. Scissors. Scissors. Cup. Cup. Saucer. Saucer. Paper towels. Paper towels. Broom. Broom. Mop. Mop. Basket. Basket. Tap. Tap. Fruit juicer. Fruit juicer. Measuring spoons. Measuring spoons. Soap. Soap. Bucket. Bucket. Tongs. Tongs. Deep fryer. Deep fryer. Toast. Toast. Coffee pot. Coffee pot. Clock. Clock. Chocolate. Chocolate. Fruit bowl. Fruit bowl. Ceiling fan. Ceiling fan. Cheese. Cheese. Matches. Matches. Egg timer. Egg timer. Funnel. Funnel. Jar. Jar. Bread bin. Bread bin. Cutlery. Cutlery.
Guys, good evening. Welcome, everybody. So you can see, maybe you're going to see teaches so many words related to the kitchen, guys. But if you see, it's exactly in the kitchen when we prepare many different things. And what you need when you're going to prepare all those things, different things, not only, cutlery, silverware, but you're going to need different kitchenware. All the things that maybe you're going to need for your preparation. So, guys, tonight, we are going to be learning lots of new words. So be very attentive. Teacher is very happy just to be with you once again. Incredible, guys. So I'm going to start showing you some of the things. Now it's about time to start. All right. So I'm going to show you. Last class, I remember, guys, that we learned a bunch, my gosh, a bunch of different words. Okay. So I'm going to erase all of them. The last one was a good one. So I'm going to show you very quickly our board, okay? Not like this, exactly as it looked last class. And if you give me just a second, I just have it just right here, okay? This one is last class vocabulary, okay? It's last class vocabulary. So lots of new or different words. I imagine lots of vocabulary that class. So the idea two and I is to expand it. I'm gonna show you very quickly this vocabulary, and I'm gonna give you the pronunciation. Appliances, canned food, sausages, can opener, sharp, wine glass, wine cup, a bottle opener, measuring spoon, sizes, recipe, to measure, measurement, read on the label, yummy, a measuring cup, chopsticks, chain restaurant, fine restaurant, luxury restaurant, fancy restaurant, a tablecloth, first class, to spill the drinks, leftover, staff, a table mat, said silverware, shaker, to shake, sandpaper, pitcher, jug and jar, to pour, pool, food and drinks, meals and drinks, cocktails, beverage, cup, mug, Chinese porcelain, teapot, the order, take an order, serving tray, a cookie sheet, a cutting board, ice trays, a coffee maker, milkshake, blender, the menu. How much do I owe you? How much is the bill? The bill comes to, and finally, a skim milk. I like that last word that we learned is milk, skim milk, because in Spanish it's like leche descremada, but that means that is low the percentage of fat. Okay, which is good because you're gonna just keep a good shape. All right, guys, so I'm gonna start showing you what exactly we are gonna be doing tonight. So we are gonna go on talking about kitchenware and all the things that probably you're gonna find inside a kitchen. All right, to do this, I'm gonna just put it this way for all of you to see very well. All right, so be very attentive every time that we find, as you know, a word that we consider important to learn. Okay, teacher, immediately is gonna write it down on our vocabulary sheet. All right, very good, guys. So I'm gonna start showing you our first one. I don't know if you remember in our previous video. If you were attentive, maybe you just watch the word, okay? So if you were attentive, teacher Alirio is gonna ask ya, showing you, all right, this. All right, guys, just for curiosity, do you remember, based on the video that you just watched, what is the name of this kitchenware? I mean, these appliances. Okay, you say waffle maker. Okay, very, very good. There's, as you know, different ways as you call all these. Okay, so I love that. It's a waffle maker in Colombia. Maybe waffles are not so common for our breakfast. You know, in Colombia, it's more arepa, eggs, chocolate, you know. But waffles are sometimes delicious. The problem is, in our culture, we are especially salty in our breakfast. You know, we are not commonly related to sweet or sweetie, you know, breakfast in the morning. For example, for me, I prefer salty food in the morning. Okay, so I imagine a waffle with a lot of syrup or maybe honey, which is obviously delicious, but it's very sweet. In the morning, I prefer salty meals. All right, very good. But yeah, that's very good. This is a waffle maker. It's very easy. You just prepare what is inside the bag with a little milk. You know, you just pour it, just close the machine, and in just no more than 5 minutes, okay, you're gonna have your waffles. Okay, so ready to be eaten, which is good, no? All right, very good, guys. Hey, listen, this artifact, this gadget, this kitchenware, all this is just incredible. But remember, this is going to consume resources such as electricity. All right, so bear that in mind. Okay, this is good, but you know. Okay, another, which is very interesting, is this. Sometimes people use it, especially nowadays, people prefer not to use them, all right? Because you know what I just mentioned, maybe your electricity bill will come very high and it's gonna be almost impossible for you to pay it, all right? This is good because maybe you're not gonna need gas or things like that. You just plug it and you just apply some oil. And maybe if you have some pork or meat or fish, it's ready to be cooked, all right? So this is good. This is an electrical skillet, all right? I'm going to just show you this one, electrical skillet, all right? So as I mentioned, maybe you're not going to be so interested just because you don't want to pay more. You know, another day, if you just can shorten your expenses, that's gonna be good. But if you're gonna use just electrical stuff in your kitchen, okay, just be ready to pay a lot of money, all right? Bear that in mind, okay? Very good. I'm gonna show you another, which is commonly used in Chinese cuisine. It's big one, it's deep, you know, you just open the cover or tap. And hey, you're gonna have a lot of room just to cook, steam, fry all your vegetables. You know, this is something that everybody knows as a wok. All right, I'm gonna write it down. Anyhow, you know what I mean. Okay, it's big one. Okay, sometimes chefs love it because they can big spoons, okay, things in a matter of seconds. And it's just delicious, especially in Chinese vegetables with pork, chicken, you know, some sauces. And this is gonna taste amazingly. All right, so a wok. Do you have a wok at your house? Or are you good at cooking with a wok? All right, so that is just a curiosity. All right, I'm gonna show you another. Maybe people got like carrots, onions, pepper, these kind of vegetables, sometimes they are grated, you know, just for prepare other things, you know. For example, in Colombia, when we see this one, it's commonly used when we are gonna prepare buñuelos. So you just grate with this thing that is called grater. A grater is used just to put the cheese in very small particles, which can be easily mixed with the one. And finally, you're gonna have that cheesy, delicious, yummy ball. All right, call in Colombia buñuelo. So please don't forget that this grater, or you can also say grater, okay, that comes from the verb grate. Okay, so sometimes you use a grater to grate different things that maybe you need to make smaller, all right? So in this way, obviously, guys, it's gonna be much easier to mix all the ingredients for a recipe, okay? Do you remember what a recipe is? And we already explained that, okay, in our last class. So maybe by now, I'm saying, teacher, don't worry. Surely I remember. Okay, I'm going to show you another that is commonly used, especially when you see an empanada place, you know. Actually, these got different names. Sometimes people put napkins just around, put the empanadas, you know, and this is going to strain all the oil. And empanadas maybe are not going to be so greasy or fatty, you know, and when you eat them, they are going to be like drier, you know. Maybe it's because you let them for some minutes to strain. All right, so I'm going to just show you the verb is to strain, dejar colar o colar algo, you know, and that is also or obviously is done with eye strainer. That is exactly that. Some people say colander, okay? That is another possibility, colander, all right? So sometimes we use colander as well, especially when our moms at home prepare a juice, for example, passion fruit. Okay, guys, I'm going to show you just right here our chat, and I would like you to tell me, do you know what fruit is passion fruit? What fruit is passion fruit? All right, that is the teacher question. Please, if you know on the chat, tell me, yeah, my gosh, Elena Barrios. Excellent. That is actually, in Spanish, maracuya is a very famous tropical fruit. And that is called passion fruit. Okay, so it's very easy. I don't know why they call it this way. In Colombia, we only say maracuya. But American people say the passion fruit. I don't know why. Don't ask me why. To be honest, I don't know. I don't have the faintest idea. Okay, a colander or an strainer. This is good, especially because you don't want to just keep just your fingers all greasy after eating an empanada. And this is good because it's going to let them strain. And finally, when you're going to eat them, they are going to be totally dry or at least as dry as you want. And it's going to be this way to eat it all. Okay, so a strainer. And don't forget what is strain. Okay, so maybe I'm going to show you the pronunciation once again. All right.
Strain.
A strain in Spanish means different things. All right. Different things, but actually don't forget it. Guys, let's go on, all right? Let's go on with another thing that maybe you're gonna find inside a kitchen and maybe it's gonna let your day be, I mean, if you have enough things how to prepare your food, okay? Not only is gonna be easier for you, but it's gonna be quicker. I mean, it's gonna take less time than usual. And I imagine if you're gonna prepare something, you don't want actually to spend such a long time. Okay, good, let's go. Another very, very commonly known, especially because it's used with oranges, sometimes with tangerines also, okay, tangerine. Okay, and these guys actually is called juicer. Teacher, I can say fruit juicer. Man, I'm not going to tell you you can say, but people say juicer. Teacher, can I say a fruit juicer? Okay, yeah. You can say a fruit juicer. Ava, remember, that is very long. And something that is going to be interesting in English, especially when you've got a communication, is that things are not only said extremely quick, but they share things as much as they can. So I imagine it's just because they want just to keep the conversation flowing. And sometimes, okay, just to shorten things made this process easy. All right, so I'm going to just move it. So a user, sometimes you don't want to eat the fruit, the orange like this. All right, actually, you want the juice, only the juice. I don't know why, but doctors nowadays say that orange juice is not healthy because the level of sugar are so high that is not so good for your health. Guys, it's amazing because you say, wow, yes, it's not good. So if maybe your granny is suffering from this, you know, maybe sugar in the blood, it's not a good idea that you offer him or her orange juice. Okay, it's not healthy. It's at least what I heard from dietitians who recommend not to drink orange juice because it's too sweet. Can you imagine that? Hey, teacher, fruit is not supposed to be healthy. Yes, but hey, I'm not a doctor. I just watch the information on television, on different programs, even on news. You know, yeah, I know it's amazing because when you talk about fruits, what you're gonna think that maybe fruit is not healthy. Okay, but sometimes it's not just as you know. I'm gonna show you another. Okay, now people don't use this. You know, they are not gonna just hammer and pound like this inside the kitchen because you're gonna look like a caveman. You know, you're gonna look like a caveman. All right, so what nowadays people commonly use, especially if they want to prepare some meat? You know, that depend on the part of the cow where maybe the meat come from, you're gonna have different quality in the meat. Some meat is not so tender. I'm gonna show you the word. When we talk about meat, cuando hablamos de la carne, hey, you say tender, tierna, suave, all right? So please don't forget tender. All right, so if you eat tender meat, obviously it's because the meat is juicy and it's easy to eat, you know, but sometimes there's meat that is and it's gonna almost break your teeth. Okay, so be careful. If you're gonna prepare this kind of meat, because maybe you didn't have enough money how to buy a first class, first rate meat. Okay, so maybe this is a good solution. It's called a meat tenderizer. A meat tenderizer, all right? I'm gonna just write it down. Okay, you say a meat tenderizer. Okay, so a meat tenderizer is exactly what you see here, okay? And a meat tenderizer led you after pounding and pounding the meat for some seconds, okay? Just to have a juicier, you know, meat. So maybe if you're gonna eat it, it's not gonna be like that, okay? So maybe you're gonna eat the meat easily. Okay, just because when you were preparing the meat, okay, you just use a meat tenderizer just to make the meat so not softer, tender. All right, please. No, it's not common. Hey, there's like a powder. There's like a powder. I'm gonna write down that word. Okay, powder. Powder. You know what is powder? Polvo. So it's different because when you go to the supermarket and you go and buy some seasons, you know, to season the meat, there's one that is like white, you know, and it say like a meat tenderizer, ablanda carnes, all right? Sometimes, okay, our moms, at home, don't use a meeting the riser because, hey, that's going to look weird, you know? But hey, anyhow, no people cook exactly the same way. Maybe if your granny is doing it at, you know, at home in the kitchen, so maybe your mom is going to look at her like, hey, your granny is almost crazy. She cooks like a cake woman. You know, he's using steel, that thing, just to make the meat something. Don't you think it's crazy? Say, yes, maybe, mom, but hey, you can just deny that what our granny prepared is delicious. I don't care how she decide to prepare or what exactly she used to prepare it, mom, but the result, let me tell you, it's amazing. All right, so please don't discuss, man. People prepare things in different ways, you know, and sometimes people use different things inside the kitchen. All right, talking about celebrations, maybe the coming one will be here for all of you. All right, I'm gonna show it to you. So if you're celebrating, you need to know that sometimes special beverage like wine, drinks like wine, they come with a cork, okay? A cork is a piece of wood that is used to seal the bottle and to keep the smell, the gases, and obviously the flavor exactly as it's supposed to be. All right, what happened if you want to drink a bottle of wine? If you want to drink a bottle of wine and this one's got a cork, my advice for you guys is please get one of these ones, because otherwise it's going to be very hard. Obviously, there's techniques or videos on YouTube where you can learn how to open a bottle of wine if maybe you don't have one of these ones. Even people use a key, you know, to open wine bottles, okay? But this is called a corkscrew, all right? I'm going to write it down, and please pay attention about the way as this word is written. You say, a corkscrew, all right? So a screw is because it's like a screw, you know? And the cork is because cork is the piece of wood that people use to seal the bottle, para sellar, all right? Very good. So you're gonna need a corkscrew, okay? Yeah, maybe you're gonna need one of these ones, okay, to seal the bottle. Not all the wines got one, this one. And sometimes, I don't know why, guys, people relate, hey, if the wine's got not a cork, it's because it's low quality. Do you think it's this way? Hay gente que piensa que si no tiene corcho, la botella de vino es de baja calidad. All right, so, okay, very good. Another is something that is especially used for all the chef, and especially like Oriental ones, you know, Chinese, Japanese, and yeah, I'm gonna show you that one, all right? Let it see. And they use it amazingly. I have seen some videos, or sometimes I watch videos, some chef preparing different food using one of these ones, and they are very skillful. They can shop all very quickly, all right? You gotta be very careful if maybe you are using one of these one at home, because you can cut one of your fingers. It's very easy to be fingerless if you don't pay attention. Okay, teacher, what is the name of this kind of knife? It's not exactly a knife. It's called a meat cleaver. Okay, guys, you say a meat cleaver, and you know what is the problem with British pronunciation? If you say cleaver, cleaver sometimes is the synonym of intelligent or smart, okay? Especially when there's like some, you know, how can I explain this missionless behavior, you know? You say cleaver. is when nobody is gonna turn you in. Nobody is gonna betray you. Nobody is gonna just play games with you because you've got some experience or knowledge. And you say clever, but that A, when is the synonym of intelligent? Here, we are talking about the kitchen. And here, we are talking about kitchenware. Different things that maybe we use inside the kitchen to prepare the meals. Okay, just focus on. I just mentioned this because maybe we have talked about the word before and I don't want you to get confused. Okay, so focus on, be very attentive. All right, another that is especially used in supermarkets or when you got a store is one of these. And people use it because you need exactly to know the quantity because depend on the quantity depends the price that you're gonna pay. So if you're gonna go and buy some chicken, you say, Mr. Pedro, could you please give me a kilo of chicken? Obviously, he's gonna put the chicken on the scale and you're gonna see like a little hand that is gonna measure exactly the quantity that this chicken weighs. All right, so I'm gonna just show you guys to weigh, el verbo pesar. All right, scale, la pesa. All right, so that is gonna give you some measurements. Eso te va a dar una medida. O la utilizas to measure, para medir. All right, so this is a scale. There are different ones. A day is, I don't know how to say, guys, no mechanical. They are digital, you know, electronic, scale, you know. So they're not going to have, you know, like this one. No, 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 no. All right. So please, you're not going to see any of those. But say, teacher, really? Yes, believe me, man. I don't know why. Everything you will believe and trust more in technology, because this one that I can show you on the screen is old fashioned one, you know. So you're not gonna see a spring. You know what is a spring? Las de ahora son digitales y ya no traen, mira cómo se dice, ¿no? Es una palabra que ya conocíamos como la palabra primavera. All right, spring también es un resorte. All right, so when you are talking about a classical scale, so maybe you're gonna see an spring. All right, sometimes people say elastic. All right, elastic. Okay, but that is especially when we are talking about the cloth. Esa es cuando hablamos de la ropa. Si hablo de la ropa, digo que tiene un resorte que es elástico, entonces digo elastic. Pero si digo spring, es un resorte de esos metálicos que cobran su forma, ¿cierto? Y lo hacen con propósitos de hacer pesas, ¿no? All right, very good. So please don't forget. So if you're gonna buy some chicken, make sure the scale is good, because sometimes people betray clients and they modify the scale just to steal clients' money. Y hay unos que como que le hacen truquitos a la pesa para robar al cliente. All right, be careful. Okay, I'm gonna just show you another one. Hey, you wanna prepare a cake? Yes, teacher. So if you wanna prepare a cake, you're gonna need one of these. All right, especially because when you prepare a cake, you need lots of eggs. No eggs, no cake. It's impossible, teacher. And what is this? You can say in English, actually, bitter. Yeah, bitter. Teacher, what? Yes, I say bitter. Maybe when you say in English, teacher, bitter, that sound like Michael Jackson's son. Yeah, maybe sounds like Michael Jackson's song, because actually the word is just right there. And you say, is exactly the word? Say, teacher, really? Yes, man. In English, people say to beat. All right? In English, people say sometimes to beat. Hey, I would like to explain about this word a little bit. All right? In English, when you say beat, actually, in Spanish, it's like dar un golpe. Sometimes people say golpear. Sometimes people use the expression beat up. And if you say beat up, you are exaggerating a little bit. And in English, beat up is como dar una paliza. All right. But actually, in English, when you say to beat, and we are talking about vocabulary that maybe we try to understand or is used inside the kitchen, is like batir, beat. Sometimes people do it handy. In English, you say handy. Okay, in English, or by hand, lo hacen a mano o lo hacen de manera manual, sorry, guys. All right, by hand. All right, but sometimes people use machines, okay? Because if you are a chef and maybe you are in the restaurant and you are preparing several dishes at the same time, so you're gonna need some help. And this help sometimes is gotten from machines. And that is good. So teacher, if I want to prepare what I need, you're going to need a beater, okay? A beater. So please don't forget this. A beater is electronic. It's easier, you know, but as I mentioned to all of you guys, you can use all these appliances, but remember that this is electricity consuming. Which means that you're going to pay more money. And it's not actually about money only, but it's also about to protect the planet. If you consume more electricity, you consume more resources, and this way you are not helping the planet. All right, so the advice all the time is, hey, use things or try to do it like back school, manually, you know, or using your hands. Okay, I'm going to show you another. This is especially used to season your meal. I love it, especially when you eat pizza or maybe when you want to season your meat, okay? You use one of these. Sometimes it's bigger. People say only a grinder. Okay, I'm going to say or write the word grinder. You know, people in Spanish sometimes say like molino, you know, like molino. So you use it, or sometimes people say picadora, but people say sometimes molino. All right, so a grinder. Okay?
Grinder.
Yeah, say grinder. Okay, so a grinder, because come from the verb to grind. Okay, this is a very important verb in English. And when you say it, immediately people think about industry, you know, because there are machines or sometimes even when we are talking about our blender, licuadoras, okay, we can use this to grind, pulverizar, reducir. All right, sometimes people in Spanish say moler. Sometimes people say triturar or even picar, okay? And sometimes you use a grind or a grinder exactly to do that, okay? Very good. Sometimes people say coffee grinder, molino de café, coffee grinder. Obviously, this is handy. Este es manual, is handy. But there are electrical ones that you can use for your coffee as well. I'm going to show you another, especially this is something that your granny maybe use a lot in the kitchen, especially because if you love cookies or another is a muffin. Okay, yeah, a muffin. Sometimes people say, teacher, what is the difference between a muffin and a cupcake? Not much, You can say muffin or you can say cupcake. I'm gonna write it down. Cupcake doesn't need any introduction, but people sometimes say the word muffin. Chocolate muffin. Oh my gosh, they are my favorite, guys. So this is a muffin pan, all right? I'm gonna write it down. Hey, I'm gonna write down two different ways. You say a muffin pan, or you can also say a muffin tray. Okay, I say this why, guys, because actually depend on your English. If it's trendy, I mean American or British English, you need to know this. Okay, very good. I'm gonna show you another. This is commonly used in restaurants. You know, the cover is translucent, obviously made in glass, sometimes in plastic, of course. And people put the batter inside. Sometimes you open the lid and the batter is just right there. You take some with your knife and spread it on the bread or on the arepa, or depend on what you're eating. All right, so it's a batter tray. A butter tray. Guys. Butter is British pronunciation. Teacher is very respectful about that pronunciation, but you already know that I commonly don't use it. Okay, I say butter. There's a very famous butter that is American, especially in the States. People consume it a lot. It's amazing. There's a very common, well-known brand of this one that is called Peter Pan. I think it's one of the most well-known one in the States. And it's peanut butter, mantequilla de maní, peanut butter. I'm going to write it down, peanut. Peanut butter is very delicious and very energetic. That is why American people consume it. All right, I'm going to show you another that is going to be very helpful, especially if you're going to take things that are very hot on the oven. Okay, don't touch. Okay, no, don't do that. Don't touch the pot, okay, with your hands, because you can burn your fingers. You don't want to, so maybe you're going to go to hospital or you need to use special creams for protection. Hey, but if you know, the things are extremely hot because you're heating the knob on the oven or microwave. Guys, use this one. It's oven mitt. Okay, I'm gonna write it down. Oven. There are ones very beautiful, colorful, and hey, if you can use for protection, you don't want to burn your fingers. Don't burn your fingers. So use an oven mitt. Sometimes it's necessary to use only one or wear only one because maybe the pot or the pan or whatever you are using to cook is not so heavy. All right. Sometimes you need to use double ones. All right. I'm going to show you another thing. This is good, especially when you're cooking and you need to turn over, especially what you are cooking. Look at how do you say turn over. Mira cómo se dice en inglés voltear la carne. All right? Si vas a voltear la carne, maybe you're preparing a burger. Estás preparando una hamburguesa. So you're gonna need an spatula. All right? You're gonna need an spatula. I'm gonna write it down. Spatula. And some people is like reusing the spatula and the meat flipping up. They take it again on the spatula. I don't know how they do it, but it's amazing. I mean, because they are very skillful and experienced chef, and they know how to use it very well. You know, that's good. I'm going to show you another. This is a whisk. Already learning from our last class. All right, anyhow, I'm gonna write it down. It's no whiskey. Please, it's a whisk. Okay, sure. So maybe when you think about it, think about whiskey. And immediately just leave out the last few layers and that's it. Immediately you'll have it. That's very good. Another is especially if you've got like a, Jack. I imagine Jack. All right. So maybe you're going to need this one. And with this, maybe you're going to pour soup, juices, or maybe different liquids. All right. This is called a lado. Okay. Sometimes maybe you're going to find some difference in pronunciation. And that depends if it's American or British.
Ladle.
Okay. It's ladle. People say ladle when it's British or ladle. Okay. This is commonly used. People nowadays maybe don't use ladles a lot because they use jars. Hay gente que no nos usa porque usan las jarritas para servir. All right. Just to pour the drink. Okay. But maybe your granny in some restaurants is still use these ones, okay, just to do, you know, or make the work. Okay, I don't know, you know, it's like back school. All right, guys, I'm going to show you once again all of them from the beginning. And we are going to try to remember together if maybe this is. Please, guys, remember, this is memory. Okay, I don't want you to impress me. No. Okay, I need just to see what you can hold in your memory. All right, that is why I'm gonna just show you our chat and I'm gonna ask you if maybe you remember what is the name. All right, please, but remember, don't betray me, don't cheat on me. No me hagas trampa, solo si la puedes recordar. Number one, guys, tell me, do you remember what is the name of this one? Very easy. Yeah, excellent, guys. Do you remember what is the name? Electrical skillet? I don't know. I don't know. All right, very good. Oh, you say a waffle maker. And remember, Luz Elena, I think, was the first one tonight. Who gave us the word? Now Sandra Milena is replying or is recalling, okay, that word. A waffle maker is not so common in Colombia, but waffles are delicious. I don't like them for the breakfast, all right? But I like waffles. Okay, I'm going to show you another one. So be just ready, okay? This is another guy. Let me see and you tell me. Do you remember what is the name of this one? Very quickly, you just plug in and it's just hot and ready to be used in a second. Do you remember what is the name of this? Obviously, Luz Elena, thank you. And that was a word that maybe Luz Elena just used before, okay? And it's electrical skillet. Good, but as I mentioned to all of you guys, be ready to pay more. Be ready to pay more. Okay, very good. Another use, especially in Japanese or Chinese cuisine. Do you remember what is the name? It's a wok. Lots of vegetable, chicken, pork, bacon. You're going to use sausages and ready to be eating in a second. Okay, very good. Another. Look at for the cheese, for different things, okay? Not only for the cheese, okay? Is a grater, okay? This is very, very good, okay? Actually, that is the word, okay? Very good. I'm going to show you another. Tell me, guys, you're going to eat a greasy empanada? You're going to just keep your fingers totally wet? You're going to need maybe a calendar. This is one, or there is a different name. Do you remember what is the other name? I don't know. I'm just asking you, do you remember that? Okay, strainer. Incredible and very useful. I use it. Especially if you're going to eat arepa de huevo, empanada, maybe things that people fry. Use it, please. Okay, it's good. Another is especially for fruits. Is for fruits. You know, tangerines, oranges. Guys, my question is, do you remember what is the name of this, you know, thing? Yes, it's a juicer. Obviously, if you don't want to say fruit, it's not necessary. You only say juicer, and that is Lucelena incredibly well. Guys, what about the rest of the class? Remember our commitment. Our commitment is you're going to be very participative on the chat, okay? That is why we're here, okay? Next one, guys, is this. It's very hard, your meat. It's not so tender. So you're going to need a meat tenderizer, okay? You'll hit the meat with this, and probably, okay, your meat will be tender. All right, another. Do you like to drink wine? And it's got a cork. If your wine's got a cork, what do you think you're gonna need? Do you remember what do you need to open a bottle of wine? It's a corkscrew, okay? Or yeah, you say screw, but it's better corkscrew, okay? So you open the bottle of wine, okay? Excellent, guys. Show you another very famous when you talk to a chef. Chef, maybe they are going to tell you, yes, I use this every single day. It's a meat cleaver. Meat cleaver. Excellent. Very good memory. Hey, you want to measure the quantity of chicken that maybe you're going to buy in the supermarket? Because if you want to do that, let me tell you, you're going to need a scale. You're going to need a scale. I'm going to show you another. What about if you're going to prepare a cake? Do you like cakes? Because if you like cakes, maybe if you want to prepare the cake quicker, you're going to need one of these ones. It's commonly used, okay, in the kitchen. You say, a what? Teacher, what? Beater. Yes, an electrical beater. I've got an electrical beater, but I never use it. I don't know why. Sometimes we are just consumers. All right, another very incredible, not only for the coffee, it's also used for the peeper, especially also for the peeper. Okay, guys, do you remember what's the name of this? Grainer. Okay, very good. What about one? Okay, here your granny just pour the special preparation, and after some minutes in the oven, magic finally comes out. Do you remember the name of this? Teacher, muffin. Do you like muffins? Oh, please. Who's gonna tell no? All right, very good. Another, what is this? It's something that people use to cover, something that we spread on the arepa. And we spread on, especially, yes, it's the butter, but this is the bar tray. Another, you don't wanna burn your hands just because the pot on the oven on the burner is extremely hot. So you're gonna hit an oven mitt, wear them, and just take whatever. Anyhow, you're not gonna get burn your fingers. This is for protection. All right, what about this one? You're going to turn over something. You want to turn over something. So use this one. It's an spatula. What about this? Especially for eggs or especially when you're going to prepare sometime your cake also. And you don't have like a beater, you know? So maybe you're going to need a whisk. Okay. And finally, guys, the last one for juices, different liquids. Okay. And it's a good idea, especially for the sancocho. Okay. It's a ladle. All right, guys, with all this, teacher is gonna tell you, I'm gonna see you next class. And I hope in our next encounter, we can turn the
Bye, teacher. Thank you.
Bye, teacher.
Bye, teacher. Bye, teacher. Bye, teacher. Bye, teacher.
Bye, teacher. Bye, teacher.
Bye, bye.